Okay, it's January 16th, 2005. I just looked at the time too. It's 1:53 p.m. I just had the tiller out here, and I only did about a width of the border of the garden. So, well, as you can see, I only did three sides too. The south side here, where the tarp is, off here. See, a lot of this is not getting tore up good. I'm not really worried so much about that either. I'm just gonna try to get this right here is tearing up good on the east end. It's about 44 feet, roughly, maybe about 46 now. And I come down here and went a little bit longer. That's north. This is the north end down here. As you can see, this one came out pretty good as I tried to widen it. Like I say, the plastic should come out to about where the grass is here, and at least half of the plastic will have dirt on top of it, you know, in just about a foot, because the center of it won't have any soil on top. You can see it's gonna be fun getting all this crap. See that stuff right there? This isn't easy. I've got no one except my wife, who's in bad shape with her back and her knee and her hip. And I got two bad knees. And I have someone that's gonna try to help me tomorrow if possible. I have to get this plastic to the edge over here because all this water, and look at that. That's just supposed to be water. What's that white stuff floating on there? Like I said, call me paranoid, whatever. I don't give a shit. I'm gonna eat the food out of this garden. I don't give a shit what you think. I'm gonna try to get this stuff drained off on the outer edge over here at least. With all the chemtrailing, I know it makes a little difference, but you know, it's something to keep my mind at ease to get rid of all this stuff. But stretch the plastic out, like I said, just beyond the grass here, and then soil. I need to have a ton of soil put out here, but I don't trust the topsoil. And here is where I stopped. See, the western end of the garden right here has got to be done. You can see the width of the I can't see with this viewfinder and the sun out here. Jesus. The width of that viewfinder, the width of that tiller coming down this way here, it's about a foot and a half, 2 feet, about eight, let's say 18 inches roughly. So some of this will be tore up right here. And then that's gotta be tore up, yeah. It's muddy right now because of the condensation, the cold. It gets down to 20s at night and then in the mid to upper 50s in the daytime, which makes this all muddy. Tomorrow's supposed to be up to about 57 if I have the help I'm hoping for. I'll have them help me get this plastic as much as possible drained off. That's going to be real hard to do. And then right now the plastic is going north and south when it should go east and west. I mean, you know what I'm saying? It's longer going north to south right now, but it's wadded up over here. And I'm going to turn it so that it goes out toward the east there. And if I have to, I'd cut it in the middle and have a little aisle in between. But I don't know. I'd rather have one solid piece. And like I say, put, you know, plastic out to the up on top of this grass here, and then have soil on top of the ends here to hold it down. And then, you know, we'll have about, let's see, how many rows across here? Let's just use round numbers, 40 feet in length. We'll have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. I'm gonna have 12 rows at least. Plus this far end here, I'm gonna have sunflowers all the way from the north end down there here to the south end. I'm gonna space them out about 10 inches apart, sunflower seeds, and just put them out in the soil. And hope for the best, because that's how they used to do it. I'm not trying to do anything that professional growers would do. I'm doing it off of scratch. I'm doing it with my back, and that tiller is the only type of mechanical equipment I have, is that old piece of junk tiller right there. It doesn't have forward and reverse, it just has forward, and I have to keep picking it up and shutting off, letting go of the gas. And the time still spins, well. But So it'll be at least 55 feet across and about 42 feet in length that way. So 12, or at least 12 rows, maybe a little bit more, depending on what goes where because of how they bush out. But the very front row here is closest on the end of the east end of the garden here will be sunflowers all the way down. Debating whether I want to do it on the west end over there too. But it'll help attract some bees, which is the only thing I gotta see what I'm gonna put here now. If I'm gonna have sunflowers right here, do I want tomatoes or peppers first? I had tomatoes and peppers on the other end down there. And I have to get a bull rake out here. Again, all manually, and try to level this out as much as I can. It's not real bad, but it needs to be leveled out before I put the plastic over it. So, and then the heirloom seeds will go out. I'm going to start planting in another 2 weeks or so when I get my disability. I'm going to buy potting soil and plant a bunch of stuff. I'm using coffee cans for 12 plants. 12 coffee cans, so I can put 2 to 3 plants in each one. And then I have a bunch of planters I used last year, which you've seen on a different video. I got so much odds and stuff. And I haven't really organized any of that stuff, but you know, I'm doing what I can. So, I was over on Highway 79. Someone was probably passing, didn't get over. Enough of that trucker's liking. So, okay, that's the survival garden, because this is it, man. 2015 is going to go hot. I'm almost positive of that this year. 2015 is going to go hot. So, if you got even a small swath next to the house by you or something, or a little piece of a garden where you can go 5 feet even, just to grow 3 or 4 tomato plants, or a tomato plant, pepper plant, whatever you want. My big thing is always tomatoes and peppers are easiest to grow. We'll have a lot. I mean, I have enough space right now, just right now. At least 98 plants, at least, right now. And then I can go from there how I want to divide that up, split up, because I don't want like 30 tomato plants and the heirloom seeds with this plastic and all puts out like 90% harvest. What am I going to do? I'm no way I'm going to be able to use all them tomatoes. I can can some. I'd like to learn how to freeze dry stuff. But like I say, we're going to have sunflowers, tomatoes, not in this order, but sunflowers on the end, but then tomatoes, okra, eggplant, peppers, and in these last 5 or 6 rows over here. And then I don't know what I have over there. I got all kinds of seeds yet, so it's going to be a big garden. A little bit overwhelming for a lot of people. It might be overwhelming for me, but I'm going to try to do the best I can with that plastic and just putting down the hole, putting a slit, a big X, and then opening it, folding the corners of the X underneath the plastic, and then putting the plant down, spacing about 18 inches apart. I've never even done the math is how bad I am. I just do it on the fly. So just imagine, just for your sake, 55 feet by 42 feet or 44 feet and 18 inches apart, so you do it. And that tells you about how many plants I can get depending on the plant. Tomatoes bush out, so they have to spread out. Thought about like sunflowers, tomatoes, peppers, tomatoes, okra, peppers, tomatoes, or something like that. You know, I don't know yet. So, just give you an idea of what to do. I mean, I got leaves from last year out here with all this rain. Unfortunately, I see something. I'm going to really try to do the best I can because I didn't know it until I got the plastic. I was told he had wheat in there. As you see on the ground there, if I'm focusing in, you'll see kernels of corn. Monsanto corn, that's going to devastate me. I'll get out here and pick up. I'll lay on the ground because I can't squat. I'll lay on the ground and pick up all these damn corns. But I have to get all this crap out of here. I don't want no Monsanto, anything I can have. I mean, all the fields around me are going to be Monsanto, whatever their color of the year, choice of the year is, flavor. So I got that to worry about. The plastic helps knock down about 60% of all the contamination. So that's why my biggest thing is to get this plastic. I got it thanks to Andy. And maybe tomorrow I'll have my help over here and get that drained off and have it turned at least. Like I say, I have to till out all this, but I have to get all this crap out of here. I saw some the other day and I almost forgot about it, but look at, see the corn? Take this stuff. This stuff's all got to come out of here. And I'll pick it up by hand if I have to. I don't care. I'm not going to be contaminated with this shit from Monsanto. So I throw this in the ditch or whatever, which is not good. It's not, what do you call it, like, environmentally sound. I don't give a shit. Well, what about Monsanto? The farmer who owns this land uses Monsanto stuff. So if he's got corn growing across over here on this other piece of land, whether he's farming it or not, I don't care. Throw it down this ditch. Okay. So that's the garden for 2015, the first stage.